What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel for another video. My name is Dalton Schwenker. Today is February 4th, 2021. I am really excited to be here today because this past weekend, and I said this in the last video, I did a competition style one rep max with my neighbor who's a powerlifter. And I'm pretty excited to share my results with you guys because I think it shows progress. It's not the best numbers in the world, but they're great numbers for me and I feel really good about them. And I think they've set me up on a path to put some real challenging goals that are going to really challenge me this year, but achievable goals that I am excited to document and hopefully crush the goals and be able to relive that journey through videos. So I'll start with 8 weeks ago where I was. 8 weeks ago, I started a strength program. It was a gym Stoppani shortcut to strength program. These were my one rep maxes before I started the program. I had a 295 pound squat. I had a 200 pound bench press and a 370 pound deadlift. Those were my numbers 8 weeks ago. This past Saturday, we did competition style. So we did squat first, then we did bench, and then we did deadlift, and we each did 3 attempts, just like you would do in a powerlifting competition. So you have to strategize these attempts because you want to hit them, because if you don't hit any of them, then you don't get to register that number. So if you go up for your first attempt and you fail it, you can try that same weight 2 more times. Odds are you're probably not gonna get it because number one, you didn't get it the first time when you were fresh. Second time, you're fatigued from the first one. Unless you really amp yourself up and get hyped, you're not gonna hit it. So that's what they call bombing out. That's the term, a powerlifting term, bombing out. And I didn't wanna do that. So I tried to be very strategic with my weights. Now this was a garage gym session, so we weren't taking it crazy seriously. So here's where I deviated just a smidge from the rules. On squat, I really focus on wanting my one rep maxes because this is gonna set me up for my next programs. So on squat, I pushed all of my 3 attempts and I still felt like I had some in the tank. So I went for a 4th attempt. I still felt like I had some in the tank. So I went for a number 5 attempt. I failed the number 5 attempt. The number 4 attempt, however, was successful. And that is now my one rep max for squat, which was 332 pounds, okay? So 8 weeks ago, I was at 295. Granted, I didn't have a spot when I did 295, so I probably could have done around 300. I just didn't feel comfortable doing that myself. But still, to 332, I feel like that is great progress in 8 weeks. So for bench, 200 8 weeks ago, I pushed 216 on Saturday, 3 attempts. And for deadlift, 3 attempts on that one as well, I pulled 402 pounds. So, like I said, not the biggest numbers in the world. Obviously, I'm not, you know, number one in powerlifting, but these are numbers that I'm very proud of. It shows hard work over 8 weeks and a determination to increase my numbers and consistency as well, because I hit the gym a lot and I love the gym. It's a big part of my day. It's probably one of the best parts of my day. And I'm excited to see where we can go over the course of 2021 with the same consistency and persistence. Because I think it's really not uncommon to add like 100 pounds to your squat if you're consistent over a year in the very beginning of like strength training. So with like the numbers that I have. So again, not the best numbers in the game, but I'm really excited about it. I'm excited to see where we can take these. And with that being said, we're gonna go to the gym. We've started a new program. This one's a power building program, which is hypertrophy and strength, because we want the size and we want the strength. That was cringy.
I am currently heading to the gym. This program is a power building program. So there's a hypertrophy component and there's a strength training component. It's difficult, very difficult. I'm going in right now and I have a pretty heavy deadlift session today. And yeah, it's rough. I probably should have waited a few more days to start this because I did all those maxes on Saturday and I jumped into this one on Monday. So I probably should have waited until like Wednesday to start this program. But me being like the stubborn person that hates rest days and I just want to get into the gym and like, you know, do it, I didn't wait. Classic overtraining type thing. But I feel good today. I'm finishing up my pre-workout. I'm super pumped for this. And I'm really, really excited to see where we can take these maxes over the next 13 weeks. I feel good. And I'm excited to take you guys with me. We're filming in the gym today. I always say that, and I never do, but we're filming today. You'd be so proud of what we made. I hope you got some beds around. Cause you're the only refuge now. For every mother, every child, every brother that's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire. I trained my leg to know why he's caught in the crossfire. And now I'm here waking up to the sun and the sound of birds. Society's anxiety deprives of all that we're blessed with. We just can't get enough, no. Heaven, if you sent us down so we could build a playground for the sinners to play as saints. You'd be so proud of what we made. I hope you got some beds around. Cause you're the only refuge now. For every mother, every child, every brother that's caught in the crossfire. That's caught in the crossfire. What is up, guys? Finished at the gym. I'm trying to turn the light on so we don't lose it. All right, there we go. Lighting's really bad in the car, but that was a very successful gym session. And that's pretty much gonna do it for this video. It's just a short video. This video is gonna be up on Sunday, and then next week I have a really, really exciting video to bring to you guys. I'm gonna sit down with Elle and we're gonna talk about 75 hard and our thoughts on it and how it was, some tips and tricks to help you guys if you are gonna do it, and also some things that we found very difficult, and just try to help you guys out if you're gonna do the program. So that's gonna do it, guys. I will see you in the next video.